प्रसाद फ्रॉम इंडियन टेक एकेडमी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू समराइज अ बुक नेम्ड नो एक्सक्यूजेस द पावर ऑफ सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन बाय ब्रायन ट्रेसी. दिस इज अ वेरी गुड बुक दैट आई हैव फाउंड एंड ब्रायन ट्रेसी इज अ वेरी गुड ऑथर. आई लाइक हिज बुक्स, आई लाइक हिज वर्क एंड देर आर डिफरेंट स्टेप्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू summarize the book and today we are going to do the things in a different way. I wanna create a mind map that I have already created a mind map and I am going through that mind map so that previously I was only talking about things and you are just listening to things but what I have planned that I will make a mind map so that you could recognize that things differently and you can I will give you the link in the description that about description for the mind map that I have created so that you can relate things and you can use that in your daily life. So the first thing that we are going to discuss about is that in this book there are four things that they have talked about and the four things are like the first thing for self-discipline to use the power of self-discipline, first thing that you need to do is time management. The second thing is problem solving. The third thing that is most important is self-discipline and work, and the fourth thing is happiness. So let's discuss about the first thing, that is time management. So what is time management? Peter Drucker say that you can't manage time, you can only manage yourself. Okay, so the thing is that you can manage the time, you can manage yourself, you can adapt to that time because time never waits for someone else. And another thing is that what you can do is you can feel the calendar, you can make a routine of things so that you can get things you can do the things in a different way and you can create value out of that time. So the more value you create, the more money you can make, the more successful you will be, the more the great kind of business you can make. So time management is very important, and if you are following Brian Tracy in his YouTube channel, then you must have seen he is always talking about time management. And there is a famous quote of I can remember the famous quote by him: if you want to be succeed in life, then take action and take action right now, by Brian Tracy. So this is a very famous quote by Brian Tracy, and in every video he talks about this, and this is a famous concept. So time management is basically when you are managing time, you are not actually managing time, you are managing yourself according to that time. So the first thing is optimize. You can optimize your day. Optimizing means getting more out of your day. So everybody gets 8 hours of sleep, and after 8 hours of sleep, the rest of the day, what you do is what makes you successful. Like everybody sleeps 8 hours per day, and the rest of the time that you get is around 16 hours. So whatever you are doing in that 16 hour will make you succeed. Whatever the time you spend, if you are spending time upon learning, if you are spending time on reading books, then they will pay off in your future. So so that depends upon the time you are using. Okay, so what you can do is you can optimize your day, you can change the process of doing things so that you can get more out of the more out of your time. So what you can do is you can delegate things, you can optimize your time, you can outsource things, you can automate things. That is how business is done, that is how you make most out of it. So when you are talking about management, if you can relate it to management, then management is all about getting things done by others. Okay, so getting things done by others is basically outsourcing things and automate things so that you can do more and more, you can create more and more value through others. So now let's talk about the ability to choose events. So everybody has the ability to choose the events that are going on in their life, what to do and what is the first priority, or you have the ability to choose to prioritizing things give the priority of the things that is happening in your life. So for example, choose what you want to do, and there are a lot of events that are going on in your life. If you need to prioritize them, the first priority second priority and third priority, and accordingly you do the things. For example, there are tomorrow is your exam, and there are a lot of events that are going on in your life, playing games, eating, cooking, reading books, and watching TV. So you need to prioritize. So what is the most priority at this particular time? The most important priority that is at this particular time is studying books, because tomorrow is my exam. So when you are prioritized team, and accordingly you are optimized, what you are doing is you are optimizing or getting more things out of your time. So the if you think about business perspective, then there are a lot of things like marketing and innovation is the most important part of your business. If you are not changing your marketing strategies or the innovation according to the market change, then because the environment that we are in right now is very dynamic, and you need to change your marketing strategy, you need to change your product, you need to bring innovation, you need to be creative in order to stay in the market, in order to be successful in your business. Okay, so what you can do is that you can prioritize things. So what is the most important priority right now? So right now, for successful, so you can arrange things in the BCG. If you talk about BCG matrix, then there are four quadrants, and you can arrange things accordingly, and you can prioritize things. If you are giving more priority to your star product, if you are giving more priority to your you need to give more priority to the question mark product, and you need to, what you want to do is that you need to get the cash out of the cash cow, and you can invest it in your star product. So that is how you prioritize things, and you need to prioritize your marketing strategy, your innovation, which are the most important part of your business. So let's talk about time management. Let's talk more about time management, what you can do. So any time consuming activity, when you are doing any time consuming activity like eating, like sleeping, having food, reading books, watching an online video, watching a book summary, anything, when you are doing any time consuming activity, okay, so first thing that you want to do is that you want to ask yourself, is it the best use of my time? So if yes, do the work right now, and if not, then don't do the work. Okay, skip that work and prioritize yourself. Prioritize the work which is most important for you right now, for which is most important for your business, which is most important for your career, for your future. Okay, so this is the essence of time management, is to set the clear priority. Okay, discipline yourself. Okay, so when you're clear the things, when you set the priority in a clear manner, then the opportunity cost of that, and analyze the opportunity cost when you are doing anything. Okay, well, is it the best use of my time? And then find out the opportunity cost, and always keep in mind the opportunity cost before using or consuming your time, because what is the most important is time. Okay, if you are talking about trading, time is most important. If you talk about your business, time is also very important. For your career, for your learning, for anything, time is very important. So there is we can create an analogy of time management also. Like for example, you have a company and you are investing your capital for an individual. If you talk about an individual, what you can invest? What are the important things that you can invest? What you can invest is, you can invest human capital, that is your mentality, your emotions, your physical energy. So how do you invest? Okay, how you invest your time, your mental ability, your emotion, your physical energy, that defines the how you invest all these things. These are the human capital. How you invest all these things brings you the result that you get. If you are investing all these things and partying on the, or wasting your time, you are wasting your emotional energy, you're wasting your physical energy, then you will get less result. You will be suffering. Okay, you cannot be successful if you are not optimizing your time, you are not optimizing the human capital that you have. So let's talk about the another concept, which is the second one, that is problem solving. So problem solving is one of the important quality, and the quality of things depends on the quality of life you get. Okay, if you talk about the top people, okay, the highly successful people in the 21st century, the highly successful people, what they are, they are like solution oriented. They don't think who created the problem or who done it. So they don't think about the problem, they don't think about the who did it or something. They just solution oriented, they create the solution. They, if you talk about the top successful leaders, then they seek problems, they want to, they put a solution to that problem and they resolve that problem by putting systems, by putting by automating things, by outsourcing things. So they seek problem, they want problem, and they create a solution for that problem. That is how they became the leader. They lead people to the solution. That is how the great leader should be. So when you get any kind of problem, when you get any kind of problem, so the world that what you are made of, you are made of steel. Okay, so when you are getting any problem, that is kind of like a test for you. Okay, life is basically a test, and show the world that what you are made of, show them the result. Life is a test, and the question that you, life is a test, and the question that you're gonna ask yourself is, if you wanna pass or you wanna fail. See, every problem has an opportunity. If you see the opportunities in the problem, then you can get the solution. But if you see the problem as a problem, then you will never get a solution out of that. And there are, in this book, the author have explained about the 9 methods of problem solving, that you can solve any kind of problem, that you can use to solve any kind of problem. So the first thing is take your time to define the problem. When you are defining the problem, when spending the time to identify the problem that your customers are having, then you can create the solution, and people will pay you according to the solution that you give. Okay, don't blame people, don't condemn people, just find out the problem and define the problem in a clear way. Okay, when you are defining things, when you are making things clear, then you get to know what is the real problem. And the second thing that you want to ask yourself is that problem, is it really a problem? A lot of times there are problems which are not really a problem, which is just a mental attitude, which is just a psychological concept that this is a problem, but actually it isn't. Okay, when you are finding a problem in the market, or when you are finding your problem in your problem that your dream clients are facing, is it actually a problem? Ask yourself. And the third thing that you want to ask yourself is, what else is the problem? Maybe this, the problem that you are looking at, is not a problem for the people. So find out the problem, what is the real problem that people are facing right now. Don't find out the problem that they are not facing. Find out the problem that they are facing. And a lot of times people usually think that they come up with an idea, and they come up with a solution to the problem, but actually the solution is not matching with the problem. So this is the time when this is the real reason of failure of many businesses. So you need to ask, what else is the real problem, and how did this problem occur? You need to ask yourself, how did this problem occur? And if you get to the root of the problem, that how did this occur, then you find the solution for that problem. And the fifth thing that you want to ask yourself is, what are the possible solutions for that problem? When you get to the root, when you identify the problem, when you ask yourself that this is a problem or not, if it is a problem, then how did it occur, and you can give a solution to that. After asking yourself what are the possible solutions that you can do, so after that, what do you want to do? you want to find out the best solution at this particular time. Okay, so there are when you're finding a problem at this problem and you are getting to the root of the problem and you want to ask what are the possible solution, you need to ask yourself at this particular time what I want to do, and then make the decision. Decision making is very important for if you talk about managers, if you talk about leaders, they are good decision makers. Okay, so when you make good decision, you can be a good leader. So this is the most important part of a problem solving. So I will recommend you to go to a book called Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. This is, there is a beautiful concept of decision making, and there are a lot of stories that you can relate to how people made decision, how and how they changed their life. And decision making is one of the most important skill that you need to have and that you need to develop. And another thing, that the eighth thing that you need to do is you need to assign the responsibilities, because you cannot do everything by your own. Okay, so you need to assign the things, like for example, you find a solution to any problem. So if you talk about ClickFunnels, then there are what they do is that they find out the problem that people are facing, they collaborate, and they, the companies, the small industries collaborate, and they go through the upsell and downsell. So what they do is that when they find out the problem in people, and when you find out anything, any kind of problem, what you can do is that you can assign the solution to different people, that you are gonna do this, you gonna do this, and you will find out the real solution to that problem. After you making the decision what to do next, then you assign the responsibilities. You cannot do everything by your own. After that, after assigning the responsibilities, what you want to do, you can set the measure of decisions. What is the most important thing that you want to, that is the first thing that I want to do, how I'm going to start the things. Okay, so these are the ninth step of problem solving, and these are, and if you are solving any kind of problem, you can, then you can refer to all these nine steps and you can ask all these things to yourself and the problem that you are facing, and accordingly you can solve the problem. So let's talk about the third thing, that is self-discipline and work. So self-discipline is also a very important concept, and self-discipline is the thing that is very important. Okay, so there is a test, there is a research that has gone, that has done with the senior executives. Okay, so what they did, that they had done a research about the, what are the most important qualities that the senior executive are looking for in a candidate, a job candidate. So 85% of the senior executive said that they need the two qualities, that the 85% of the senior executive said that the two qualities are the most important qualities that they are looking for in any candidate who are looking for a job. So the first thing is the ability to set priorities and work on high value tasks. And the second thing is discipline to get the job done and quickly. Discipline is one of the most important thing. Okay, so what you can do is that you can set the priorities, you can work on the high value task on the first thing. The first thing that you wanna do is that you can start with the high value things. Okay, and the second thing is you can discipline yourself to get the job quickly. How you can get the job done quickly and well, that defines how efficient you are. Okay, how effective you are, how effective you will be for the company. So what, how you can get the job done quickly, you can outsource things, you can automate, you can delegate, or even sometime you can eliminate things. When you are working when you have a business, when you have some products, so what you want to do is that you can eliminate, if you talk about the BCG matrix, you can eliminate the dog products which you are just feeding your money. Okay, so this is in the management perspective. So now I'll be talking about the happiness, which is the most important thing. So let's talk about the importance of happiness. There are three measure of success, and nothing is more important than happiness. And happiness is basically the true measure of success. If you are not happy with your life, this is the true measure of success. If you are not happy, then you are not successful. So when you are, nothing is more important than this. And if you talk about happiness, it is basically all happiness is all totally related to the effectiveness of your time, the time you are spending. If you're doing things differently, if you're getting things done faster than others, then you will be more happy. Okay, so there is a famous book called the Maximum Achievement book. There is the Law of Control. Okay, so you can refer to this book also. Another thing is, there is a famous quote that I have written here. This is, you feel happy to the degree to which you feel you are in control of your life, and unhappy to the degree to which you are not in control. So happiness is totally related to control. Okay, so you are, the effectiveness of your time, the how much you are in control of your life. So there are yogis and there are sadhus who are living in the Himalayas and all. So these are the spiritual concept that they are usually happy with their life, because they are totally in control of their own life. That is why they are much more happier. So now let's talk about the five ingredients. The author has explained about the five ingredients of success, which are most important. So what you want to do is that you become what you think about. Okay, if you think that you are happy, then you will be happy. This is a famous concept of Think and Grow Rich, and I really love this concept. And let's talk about the five ingredients of success. So if you, the first thing that is the first ingredient of success is health and energy. If you don't have health, if you don't have good health, if you are suffering from illness, if you are not taking care of your health, then you will not be you will not feel happy. Okay, because both our mind and body are interconnected. If your body is not well, then your mind will never be well. If your mind is not well, then your body will never feel healthy. Okay, that is how they are interconnected with each other. Okay, first the conscious mind, then the subconscious mind, and your subconscious mind is totally connected with your body. Then the second thing that is importance of happiness is happy relationship with the family, relationship with your spouse, relationship with your colleagues, good relationship with your with the people that are around you. Okay, so good relationship, good happy relationship relates to happiness. If you are in a good relationship, if you are in, if you have people who really care about you, then you will get much more happiness with that. And the third thing that is the most important measure of happiness is the meaningful work, the work that you are doing. If it ask yourself, if it is meaningful work, are you giving any value to the society, the work that you are doing? But doing this work, are you giving any kind of value to the society? If you are not, then you will not never be happy. And the fourth thing that is most important for happiness is financial independence. So how you can get financial independence? You can outsource things, you can delegate things, you can automate things, you can do business with that, and you can solve problems of people. And by doing all these things, you can get financial independence. If you put value in the society, if you put value to the ether, then it will give you value in terms of monetary value or in terms of any kind of value. Okay, you can get the value out of that. So the fifth thing is self-actualization, that actualizing that who you are, and whatever you think, you become. And this is a great concept, and even related to self-actualization also. So these are all the things that I want to explain about this topic. The No Excuses, The Power of Self-Discipline. And I really love this book, and if you want this mind map, then you can go to the description and download the mind map also. And if you apply all these things in your life, you will definitely get definitely be successful with your life. You will never regret that you have spent your time or spend your day in wrong way. Okay, So I hope this video has given you a clear intuition that how you can maximize your time, how you can optimize your time and automate, delegate, and how you can get things done much more faster. I hope this video is helpful, and thank you guys. Bye bye.